126, to Allah alone belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth, and Allah is fully aware of everything. 127, they ask you, O Prophet, regarding women, say, it is Allah who instructs you regarding them. Instruction has already been revealed in the book. Concerning the orphan women, you deprive of their due rights, but still wish to marry also helpless children, as well as standing up for orphans' rights, and whatever good you do is certainly well known to Allah. If a woman fears indifference or neglect from her husband, there is no blame on either of them if they seek fair settlement, which is best. Humans are inclined to selfishness, but if you are gracious and mindful of Allah, surely Allah is all aware of what you do. 129, you will never be able to maintain emotional justice between your wives, no matter how keen you are. So do not totally incline towards one, leaving other in suspense. And if you do what is right and what are mindful of Allah, surely Allah is all forgiving, most merciful. 130. But if they choose to separate, Allah will enrich both of them from His bounties. And Allah is ever bountiful, all wise. 131. To Allah alone belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth. Indeed, we have commanded those given the scripture before you, as well as you, to be mindful of Allah. But if you disobey, then know that to Allah belongs whatever is in the heavens and the earth, and Allah is self-sufficient, praiseworthy. 132. To Allah alone belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth, and Allah is sufficient as a trustee of affairs. 133. If it is His will, He can remove you altogether, O humanity, and replace you with others, and Allah is most capable to do so. 134. Whoever desires the reward of this world, then let them know that with Allah are the rewards of this world and the hereafter, and Allah is all-hearing, all-seeing. 135. O believers, stand firm for justice as witness of Allah, even if it is against yourselves, your parents, or close relative. Be they rich or poor, Allah is best to ensure their interests. So do not let your desires cause you to deviate from justice. If you distort the testimony or refuse to give it, then know that Allah is certainly all aware of what you do. 136. O believers, have faith in Allah, His messenger, the book He has revealed to His messengers, to His messenger, and the scriptures He revealed before. Indeed, whoever denies Allah, His angels, His books, His messengers, and the last day has clearly gone far astray. 137. Indeed, those who believed then disbelieved, then believed and again disbelieved, only increasing in disbelief, Allah will neither forgive them nor guide them to the right way. 138. Good news of a painful punishment to hypocrites. 139. Who choose disbelievers as allies instead of the believers, डू दे सीक ऑनर एंड पावर थ्रू दैट कंपनी? सियरली ऑल ऑनर एंड पावर बिलोंग्स टू अल्लाह। 140. He has already revealed to you in the book that when you hear Allah's revelations being denied or ridiculed, then do not sit in that company unless they engage in a different topic, or else you will be like them. Surely Allah will gather the hypocrites and disbelievers all together in hell. 140. The hypocrites are those who wait to see what happens to you. So if Allah grants you victory, they say to you, were we not on your side? But if the disbelievers have a share of victory, they say to them, did we not have the advantage over you? Yet we protected you from the believers. Allah will judge between all of you on the day of judgment, and Allah will never grant disbelievers a way over the believers. 142. Surely the hypocrite seeks to deceive Allah, but he outwits them. When they stand up for prayer, they do it half-heartedly, only to be seen by people, hardly remembering Allah at all. 143. Torn between belief and disbelief, belonging neither to these believers nor those disbelievers, and whoever Allah leaves to stray will never find them away. 144. O believers, do you take disbelievers as allies instead of believers? Would you like to give Allah solid proof against yourselves? 145. Surely the hypocrites will be in the lowest depths of the fire, and you will never find for them any helper. 146. Except those who repent, mend their ways, hold fast to Allah, and are sincere in their devotion to Allah, they will be with the believers, and Allah will grant the believers a great reward. 147. Why would Allah punish you if you are grateful and faithful? Allah is ever appreciative, all-knowing. 148. Allah does not like negative thoughts to be voiced, except by those who have been wrong. Allah is all-hearing, all-knowing. 149. Whether you reveal or conceal a good or pardon an evil, surely Allah is ever-pardoning, most capable. 150. Surely those who deny Allah and His Messenger and wish to make a distinction between Allah and His Messenger, saying, we believe in some and disbelieve in others, desiring to forge a compromise,